Hey guys, my name is Dion and welcome to this Surfshark tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to download the app, set it up, take you through the features as well as its settings, and show you how to start using Surfshark on your Mac. First, to download the app, be sure to click the links in the description where you will find the best possible deals for Surfshark. After creating your account, you will see this page where you will find all of Surfshark's supported devices and operating systems. As you can see, they support all major desktop and mobile operating systems, even supporting browser extensions and smart TVs. Surfshark also gives you the ability to connect an unlimited number of devices to your account. It is great to see this extensive level of support and coverage to ensure all of your devices are protected. On the left, it will automatically give you a recommended download, in my case, macOS. Clicking this will give you the option to download either directly from the website or from the Mac App Store. Let's go with the Mac App Store. And this will automatically launch the Mac App Store, allowing you to download the app as you would any other application. Once the download is complete, it's time to open Surfshark. When launching the app, what immediately stands out is that the app runs entirely in the menu bar, unlike, for example, NordVPN, which gives you the option to also run a window or both. Personally, I like having the app in the menu bar, as this way it doesn't take up a window and allows you to quickly make adjustments to the VPN whilst using other apps. First things first, I'm going to show you how to connect, and we'll then dive deeper into the user interface, settings, and we'll have a brief demo at the end. So, to connect, simply click the Connect button. The first time you do this, you will have to grant Surfshark certain permissions, but otherwise that is all it takes. One click and Surfshark is now ready to go. It will auto-connect to the fastest server for your given location. And you can see this also connects very quickly. Clicking this arrow here will reveal your IP address as well as the option to turn on or off the kill switch. I definitely suggest you always keep this feature on as the kill switch is in place to prevent any data leaks in case the VPN connection drops by automatically ending the session. Now let's dive deeper into the user interface. Surfshark has quite a simple and easy to navigate interface. Everything is essentially broken down into these four sections here, found in this column on the far left side of the window. And we'll work our way through each of these menus. Starting with the Locations tab, which is the tab the app launches into. Here we have the full list of countries as well as individual cities and states to connect to. There's also the option to search for a given location. Next to each location are two icons. The first will actually show you how many users are using a given location. This is really interesting information to see as it shows the current level of demand for each location. The second icon lets you save a location to make it more easy to find in the future under the favorites section at the top of the list. Next to locations is static IP. This feature, also known as dedicated IP, is where Surfshark will give you one consistent IP, as indicated by the small s by the location's name. This is useful when using apps such as online banking, where logging in from different IPs and different countries can cause security-related issues. From this list, you can still choose a specific country to connect to. The list is not as extensive compared to the full list of locations, but still gives you plenty of options. On the right of static IP, we have multi-hop. Now, multi-hop, also known as double VPN, will connect you through two servers, making your connection even more secure. Now, bear in mind, this may decrease your speeds. You can see there's quite a selection of options here, all with two different countries. Okay, so that gives you an overview of the Locations tab. Let's look at the other options in this column. Now, the button here at the very top will allow you to minimize the interface even further, to only show your current connection status. Opening any of the menus beneath it will expand it once again. Moving down the column, we have the Features tab. This is where the CleanWeb setting can be turned on or off. In essence, CleanWeb will act to block certain pop-ups while you're browsing. Last in the column is the Settings tab. First, under the Settings tab, we have the option to turn on or off Auto Launch at Login. This is something that I always like to keep on. Beneath that, we have the option to show or hide the dock icon, and this is the icon that you see right here in your dock. Now, since the application runs entirely in the menu bar, you can get rid of this dock icon. Bear in mind though, the dock icon as well as your menu bar icon will both change depending on your connection status. As you can see, if I disconnect, the menu bar icon turns hollow and the dock icon turns gray. Whilst reconnecting, we'll turn the dock icon green and the menu bar icon full, making it very easy to see whilst using other apps. Scrolling down to the connectivity section here, first we have the option to turn on or off auto connect. This will automatically connect your VPN when using Wi-Fi. This is great, especially when using public Wi-Fi. Turning this on will allow you to add a list of trusted networks, ensuring Surfshark will only auto connect when you're on an untrusted network. For example, I added my home Wi-Fi as a trusted network. Beneath that, you will once again find the kill switch option. Finally, in the advanced section, we can change the VPN protocol. Now, if you're new to VPNs, I definitely suggest keeping this on automatic, and Surfshark will choose the best protocol for your use case. Alternatively, IPv2 is the general industry standard, but these days we're also seeing WireGuard more and more. WireGuard is also generally known as the faster protocol. Now, UDP and TCP are also useful. UDP is generally seen as faster, while TCP is more reliable. Going back into the settings here, we have the account tab. And this is where you'll find a breakdown of your account as well as your subscription details. And lastly, we have the help tab. This is where you'll find a button that will link you to an extensive list of helpful guides and resources found on Surfshark's website. I'm so glad to see Surfshark have included this directly into the app, especially for new users. Now that you know how to get started with Surfshark and have an overview of the user interface as well as the settings, let me quickly show you a demo. In this example, I will quickly connect to Korea to show the Korean Apple Store. This is as simple as clicking on the location in the list, and you'll see that nearly instantly it will reconnect. In my experience of using several VPNs, I found Surfshark to be an incredible value option that is easy to set up and use. And that gives you an idea of how to get started and how to use Surfshark. If you're interested in Surfshark, be sure to check the links in the description where I will have the best possible deals. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section, and please like and subscribe if this video helped you out. Thanks for watching, guys.